Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Internal Combustion Engine. This is lecture number 5, Fuels and Combustion in IC Engine. We recap from the previous lecture. So, in the previous 4 lectures, we studied about the 4-stroke cycle petrol engine, 4-stroke cycle diesel engine, 2-stroke cycle petrol and diesel engine, and we compared the petrol and the diesel engine, and also we compared the 4-stroke cycle engine and 2-stroke cycle engine. So the basic kinematics and working principle of IC engine is over. Now we start with the fuels. In this topic we are going to discuss about the SI engine fuel and its qualities, CI engine fuels and its qualities, rating of fuel, calorific value of the fuel, combustion of the fuel. So the basic things about all these topics. At the end of the lecture, the student will discuss the qualities required for SI engine fuel. The student will describe the qualities required for CI engine fuel, and the student will define cetane number and octane number, and the student will state the air fuel ratio and equivalent ratio. So the learning outcome for this lecture. Fuels used in the IC engines. What is the importance or duties of the fuel? So, the fuel is the source of energy in an internal combustion engine, which releases the heat energy during the combustion process. So, the chemical energy of the fuel is released by burning, so by initiating the combustion. Any fuel, it contains hydrogen and carbon. So, any fuel is hydrocarbon. So, any fuel, for example, solid fuel, liquid fuel or gaseous fuel is hydrocarbon. It contains carbon molecules and the hydrogen molecules. So, during the combustion, so the reaction between carbon molecules, hydrogen molecules with the oxygen in the air, that is what the combustion of the fuel. So, we will study about the energy released by the burning the fuel. The heat energy released by combustion of fuel is converted to mechanical energy by the engine. So, we have engine mechanism. The piston cylinder arrangement, crank, connecting rod, so all the mechanical system is there. So, the heat energy produced by the combustion of the fuel is converted into mechanical energy by the engine. The type of fuel used and its characteristics are very important because they influence the design, efficiency, output, reliability and durability of the engine. So, what kind of fuel, what is the quality of the fuel? It is very important in the design of the engine. Also, the fuel and its combustion characteristics influences on the atmospheric pollution. So, the main contributor for atmospheric pollution is automobile. So, the gases, the gas emitted by the automobile, they give the environmental pollution. Nowadays, there are standards. In India, it is BS4. The standard we have to follow. So, the BS4 standard that is specify the amount of various pollutant released by the engine. So, they control the parameter, the emission of the diesel engine or petrol engine or any automobile engine. So, the fuel and its combustion characteristics influence the atmospheric pollution, the effluent from the combustion gases or the exhaust gases, they influence the atmospheric pollution. Some important requirement of good fuel. So, if you select a fuel as for IC engine, it is necessary the following qualities are required: low ignition point, high calorific value, good combustion qualities and higher combustion efficiency, high thermal stability, low toxicity, low pollution, easy to store and convenient for transportation, low deposit forming tendency. So, low ignition point. So, the temperature at which the fuel starts burning, that is what ignition temperature or ignition point, it should be low. And the higher calorific value, the calorific value that is specified, the amount of heat content of the fuel. So higher calorific value means by burning the fuel, we will produce more amount of heat energy. The fuel will release more amount of heat energy on combustion. Good combustion quality and higher combustion efficiency. So the fuel should completely burn. So it should produce more amount of heat energy and it should completely burn. Higher thermal stability. So actually it should be stable thermally before combustion, it should not react chemically. That is very important. Low toxicity. So the irritation. So it is very important for a human being. So the fuel should not be toxic. So low toxicity and low pollution. So the polluting gases emitted by the engine fuel should be less. Easy to store and convenient for transportation, and the low deposit forming tendency. So it should not form any deposits on the engine components in the combustion chamber as well as in the exhaust valve port or the exhaust manifold. So these are all the requirement for a good fuel to be used in the engine. The SI engine fuels and its qualities. So if you select the fuel for SI engine, that is petrol engine, so the qualities required are volatility, anti-knock property, gum deposit and sulfur content. The fuel used in the spark ignition engine are gasoline, which is a mixture of various hydrocarbons such as paraffins, olefins, naphthenes and aromatics. In spark ignition engine, the fuel air mixer is prepared outside the engine, outside the engine combustion chamber and admitted during the suction stroke. So there is one device called the carburetor used in the SI engine, so which is preparing the air and fuel and at the correct proportion, and then it admits into the engine cylinder. So the SI engine fuel, it is a mixture of paraffins, olefins, naphthenes and aromatics. When you select the petrol for the SI engine fuel or any gas for the SI engine fuel, so it should have the following qualities: volatility, anti-knock property, gum deposit and sulfur content. So we will see one by one. Volatility. The volatility of liquid is, in general, it is a tendency to evaporate under the given set of conditions. So for example, for the petrol, it should evaporate at atmospheric pressure and temperature condition. Then only in the carburetor, it will easily mix with the air. So the volatility of the petrol should be higher. For SI engine, the volatility should be higher. So it should tendency easily to evaporate at the given operating condition. For spark ignition engine, the certain quantity of fuel should vaporize at room temperature for easy starting of the engine. So that is very important. At room temperature, it should evaporate. The fuel should have good vaporization characteristics in the engine operating range. So it should have good vaporization characteristics. It is what called as volatility. However, high rate of vaporization of gasoline can upset the carburetor. So more amount of evaporation will upset the carburetor, and this is called as vapor lock. It will block the flow of the air fuel mixture in the carburetor. So that also should be avoided. So it will have sufficient vaporization characteristics, that is called volatility of the fuel. Anti-knock property. Abnormal combustion or detonation in the SI engine combustion chamber causes very high rate of heat release. So the abnormal combustion we will discuss later. So the abnormal combustion, it is due to the high rate of energy release. So excessive temperature and pressure inside the engine cylinder adversely affect the thermal efficiency. When you have abnormal combustion, that will reduce the efficiency of the engine. So the fuel should resist the tendency to produce detonation, and this property is called as anti-knock property. So the detonation or the abnormal combustion should not happen in the IC engine combustion. So the fuel what we use for the SI engine should have the tendency to reduce the anti-knocking in the combustion chamber. It depends on the self-ignition temperature of the fuel. chemical composition and molecular structure. So the Antinac property depends on the self ignition temperature of the fuel, chemical composition and molecular structure. Gum deposit. So the content of the fuel should not form any deposit on the engine surface. So reactive hydrocarbon and impurities in the fuel have a tendency to oxidize upon the storage and form liquid and solid gummy substances. So it may also deposited in the valve, manifold or in the and on the engine. So this is undesirable property of the fuel. There should not be any impurities. The main requirement is there should not be any impurities, and the impurities should not oxidize and form a deposit on the engine components. That is what the gum deposits. And the sulfur content, so normally in the Indian condition, the sulfur content of the fuel is very less, very, very less. So this point is general point. So the fuel should not have sulfur. So because sulfur is a corrosive element. So sulfur is a corrosive element of the fuel that can corrode the fuel line, carburetor, injection pump, and should be low in the fuel. Normally, sulfur content is a main problem in the case of the solid fuel like coal. So, for petrol or diesel, the sulfur content is negligible in Indian conditions. And the CI engine fuel and its qualities. So, for the petrol engine, we require 5 qualities. So, the volatility, Antinac property, gum deposit, and sulfur content. So, these 4 properties are required, and we take the CI engine fuel and its qualities. So, for CI engine, so in the combustion ignition engine, the fuel is injected at the end of the combustion stroke in automated form. So, using a fuel injector, we are spraying the fuel in the combustion chamber in the automated form. So, using high pressure fuel, so the pressure of the fuel injection is around 200 times the atmospheric pressure. The injected fuel is vaporized and mixed with the air, and the combustion is initiated using the high temperature of the air at the end of the combustion stroke. So, there are 3 levels: atomization, vaporization and mixing. So, the fuel is atomized, it is sprayed in the form of atoms, and because of the small tiny particle, the vapor, it is vaporized and mixed with the air, and before it is burning, so and start the combustion. So, it is initiated. The combustion is initiated using the high temperature air at the end of the combustion stroke. So, the self-ignition temperature of diesel fuel should be sufficient to ignite at the correct time as the design of the engine. So, normally the self-ignition temperature of the diesel fuel should be lesser. So, the lesser than the other type of petrol engine. So, petrol engine, there is a spark plug to initiate the combustion. But in the case of diesel engine, the fuel should have low self-ignition temperature. The important qualities of CI engine fuels are knock characteristics, volatility, starting characteristics, smoke and odor, viscosity and corrosion and wear. Now, we will see one by one. So, knock characteristics, knocking, again as we discussed in the SI engine, so knocking is the abnormal combustion of the CI engine due to increased ignition lag. The fuel should have the tendency to reduce the knock. So, any fuel, either this is SI engine fuel or CI engine fuel, the tendency of knocking. So, this fuel should reduce the tendency of knocking. Volatility, the fuel should be sufficiently volatile in the operating range of temperature to produce good mixing of combustion, mixing and combustion. So, the volatility, as we told already, it is the vaporization characteristics of the fuel. So, it should evaporate or it will become vapor at in the operating condition. So, it will easily mix with the air, and the burning combustion efficiency will be better. So, volatility will help the efficient burning of the fuel. Starting characteristics, the fuel should help in starting the engine easily. This requirement demands high enough volatility to form a combustible mixer readily and a high CTN rating in order that the self-ignition temperature is low. So, for starting characteristics, so the fuel should have the enough volatility and the low self-ignition temperature, higher CTN number. So, higher CTN number, low self-ignition temperature and the higher volatility, they are the starting characteristics. Smoking and odor. The fuel should not promote either smoke or odor in the engine exhaust. So, generally good volatility is the first prerequisite. to good mixing and therefore complete combustion. So when there is complete combustion, there is no, the smoke and odor will be very less. So for complete combustion, you should properly mix. So for proper mixing, a good volatility is required. So volatility will promote better mixing of the air and the fuel, which will leads to complete combustion of the fuel, which will reduce the smoke and odor in the engine. Viscosity, viscosity of the fuel should be low for efficient flow of the fuel. So in the case of diesel engine, we are pumping the fuel with the help of a pump. So the reduce to have a minimum pumping power, the viscosity of the fuel should be low. And the corrosion and wear, the fuel should not cause corrosion and wear to the engine components before or after combustion. So it is also important characteristic. So corrosion wear will not occur due to the content of the fuel. So these are all the requirement for the CI engine or diesel engine fuel. Rating of the fuel. Normally fuels are rated for their anti-knock qualities. The rating of fuel is done by defining two parameters called octane number and cetane number for gasoline and diesel fuel respectively. So for octane number for gasoline or petrol fuel and the cetane number for diesel oil. So the directly measuring the octane number or cetane number is not possible. So we are comparing certain qualities. So octane number is defined as the percentage by volume of isooctane and normal heptane, which exactly matches the anti-knock intensity of the fuel in a standard engine under the set of operating conditions. So we test with isooctane and normal heptane. So we test with the isooctane normal heptane as a fuel, and we take the knocking intensity of the fuel at the standard engine under set of operating conditions. Then we compare that observation with the diesel, with the petrol combustion. Then we give the octane number rating. So it is defined as the percentage by volume of isooctane and normal heptane, which exactly matches the knocking intensity of the fuel in a standard engine under set of standard operating conditions. Similarly, cetane number of the fuel is defined as the percentage by volume of normal cetane in a mixture of normal cetane and alpha methyl naphthalene, which has the same ignition characteristics as the test fuel when the combustion is carried out in a standard engine under specified operating conditions. So here we are burning a mixture of normal cetane and alpha methyl naphthalene, which is matching with the ignition characteristics of the test fuel. So the octane number for petrol and gas fuels, and cetane number for the diesel oil. Then we take the calorific value of the fuel. So the amount of heat produced due to combustion per kg of fuel is called as calorific value. It is expressed in kilojoules per kilogram for solid and liquid fuels, and kilojoules per meter cube for gaseous fuel. So the amount of heat produced under standard conditions due to the combustion per kg of fuel is called as calorific value of the fuel. And we have two calorific values, higher calorific value or gross calorific value, lower calorific value or net calorific value. The net calorific value is used for the laboratory, all the calculations we are doing with the lower calorific value. What is the difference between higher calorific value and the lower calorific value? As I told already, we have the carbon and hydrogen in the fuel. So carbon burns with the oxygen that produces CO2, and hydrogen burns with the oxygen that produces H2O. So H plus O2 that gives the H2O. The H2O will be available in the gas in the form of vapor. So that is called as water vapor. So when the water vapor is condensed and the heat is recovered, then it is called as higher calorific value. When the water vapor is not recovered and the water vapor leaves as water vapor, then it is called as lower calorific value. So higher calorific value, gross calorific value, or higher heating value, the water of combustion is entirely condensed and that heat contained in the water vapor is recovered. That is called as higher calorific value. And the lower calorific value or net calorific value or lower heating value, LHV, the product of combustion contains water vapor and that the heat in the water vapor is not recovered. So in all our calculation, the calorific value what we use, it is only the net calorific value or lower calorific value of the fuel. So the higher calorific value equal to lower calorific value plus the mass of water vapor per mass per kg of fuel into latent heat of evaporation at the given pressure or temperature of combustion. So mass of water vapor per kg of fuel into latent heat of evaporation of the water vapor. Then the combustion of the fuel. So the equation for complete combustion of any hydrocarbon fuel, it is given like this. So CaHb plus A plus B by 4 O2 plus 3.773 N2 is equal to, sometimes it is called, somebody says it is 3.76 N2 equal to ACO2 plus B by 2 H2O plus 3.773 into A plus B over 4 N2. So the air contains oxygen and nitrogen, the fuel contains carbon and hydrogen, so it produces, the products are CO2, H2O and nitrogen. So nitrogen we leave as nitrogen, it is inert in the combustion process, but in the case of diesel engine at a higher temperature, when the temperature inside the engine is higher, the nitrogen will react with the oxygen and produces nitric oxide, that is at a higher temperature. Normally the combustion gases does not have any nitrogen combustion, nitrogen oxide, so it leaves as nitrogen. Now the stoichiometric or chemically correct air fuel ratio, that is called as air fuel ratio, equal to 34.56 into 4 plus y divided by 12.011 plus 1.008 y, so where y equal to b by a. So b is the number of hydrogen molecule divided by a is the number of carbon molecule. So the chemically, so the, this is the formula to calculate the stoichiometric or chemically correct air fuel ratio, that is the amount of air required for complete combustion of the fuel, it is called as chemically correct air fuel, the chemically correct amount of air. We take petrol, it is mentioned C8H18 as the chemical formula. So C8H18 plus 8 plus 18 by 4 O2 plus 3.773 N2 equal to 8CO2 plus 18 by 2 H2O plus 3.773 into 8 plus 18 by 4 N2, that gives 12.5, that means 1 kg of fuel, it requires 12.5 kg of air, and it produces 8 kg of CO2 and 9 kg of H2O and this much quantity of N2, and a stoichiometric or chemically correct air fuel ratio for petrol, so A by F at stoichiometric condition. So it is the, this is the formula here, y equal to 18 by 8 equal to 2.25, and substituting the air fuel ratio for petrol is 15.13. So the theoretical or stoichiometric or chemically correct air fuel ratio for petrol is 15.13. That means for every kg of petrol we require 15.13 kg of air. And similarly diesel, so it is C10H22. So substituting C10H22 plus 10 plus 22 by 4 O2 plus 3.773 N2, that is equal to 10 CO2 plus 22 by 2 H2O plus 3.773 into 10 plus 22 by 4 N2, and simplifying C10H22 plus 15.5 O2 plus 3.773 N2 equal to 10 CO2 plus 11 H2O plus 3.773 into 15.5 into N2. And here the stoichiometric chemically correct air fuel ratio for diesel, here y equal to a by b equal to b by a equal to 22 by 10 equal to 2.2, and air fuel ratio is 15.06. So here what do you mean by the 15.06? For every kg of diesel we require 15.06 kg of air for complete combustion. So this is theoretically air required, stoichiometric air required or chemically correct air fuel ratio. That is what the, that is the, for both petrol and diesel it is 15, we can fix it up 15. And another parameter important for the combustion, equivalence ratio. So phi is the equivalence ratio, actual fuel air ratio divided by stoichiometric fuel air ratio. So look at the definition, it is fuel air ratio. So mass of the fuel divided by mass of the air, actual conditions, and the mass of the fuel by mass of the air for stoichiometric conditions. So when the phi is less than 1, it is called as lean mixer. So lean mixer means there is excess amount of air and lesser amount of fuel. When phi equal to 1, it is stoichiometric mixer. So there is the required amount of air is provided in the stoichiometric mixer. When phi is greater than 1, This is called as rich mixer. That means the amount of fuel is higher, the amount of air is less. So, in the case of for any engine, so we require, sometimes we require rich mixer, sometimes we require lean mixer. So, depending on the operating condition of the engine. So, 5 is less than 1, lean mixer. 5 is greater than 1, rich mixer. 5 is equal to 1, stoichiometric mixer. And the excess air, so sometimes the engine is operating with the excess air. The amount of air supplied is more than the theoretical minimum air required is known as excess air in the engine cylinder. And the combustion efficiency of the IC engine. So, combustion efficiency is the actual amount of heat released by combustion of the fuel divided by mass of the fuel into calorific value. Actual amount of heat released, actually normally it is measured with the help of a calorimeter, bomb calorimeter, Junkers gas calorimeter. They are the instrument used for measuring the combustion, heat released by the fuel. So, combustion efficiency normally for IC engine, it is more than 98%. The combustion efficiency is normally more than 98% in the case of IC engine. So, we stop here and we have a reflection spot. We will compare octane number, cetane number, lean mixer, rich mixer, stoichiometric mixer, lower calorific value, the other part, less amount of air, more amount of air, correct amount of air, higher heating, a heating value of water vapor not recovered, diesel, petrol, heating value of water vapor recovered. So, we will combine octane number, it is connected with the petrol, cetane number connected with the diesel, lean mixer, so more amount of air, less amount of fuel, rich mixer, less amount of air, more amount of, so the mixer is rich in fuel, that is the rich mixer, and stoichiometric mixer, correct amount of air, lower calorific value, heating value of the water vapor not recovered. So, these are all the correct answers. So, if you have selected the correct answers, you are good. So, thank you for watching. And these are all the reference book I used for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it. I have published a book on thermal engineering. You can refer to it. Other IC engine book also you can refer for the additional information about the topic. And thank you for watching. You can please post your comments on the comment box on the video. Immediately after the video, you just click the comment box and pass on your comments. So, subscribe the YouTube channel. I have uploaded more than 160 videos on heat transfer, thermal engineering, thermodynamics. So, it will be useful for your learning. And if you have any queries, you can write to my mail ID and you can WhatsApp to my number. I will sincerely answer. So, thank you for watching and I will meet again.